It used to be that two monitors was only for business users. But these days, whether you're a worker, a gamer, a streamer, multiple monitors have gone from being a luxury to being almost essential. I mean, you know who you are, with the stream playing during your Zoom meeting, or the latest Mr. Beast shenanigans next to that boring tutorial that you're really watching. But what if I told you that there's a dark side to your harmless little habit? That's right, your extra monitors are costing you more than just desk space and power consumption. I am talking about performance. How much? Well, the general consensus is that that's not really enough to matter. But considering the lengths that gamers will go for another 3 frames per second, I disagree. So we set the labs team loose to settle this debate once and for all. Is this why you're stuck at Silver 2? Is this why you can't get sponsored by
Origin PC? This August, get up to $1,000 off Origin PC's 30 series laptops, $200 off their desktops, and $100 off their 40 series laptops. Learn more using the link below. That's a lot of discount.
To cover all our bases, the labs team needed a lot of gear. A high-end test bench, a variety of popular games, and 4 displays that we then ran at either 1080p or 4K. They then set out to ensure that the physical displays were the only variable, which is how we ended up with a pretty unusual starting config. 3 Edge browser windows, each running the same 4K YouTube video in the background with our game out front. We recorded performance, shut down the system, plugged in a second monitor, dragged 1 of our background videos over to the secondary monitor, and reran the tests. Then for you megataskers out there, we did the same thing, but with 4 displays. And right out of the gate, the results were pretty shocking. At 1080p, even with all 4 monitors in use, this only cost us 1% performance in Red Dead Redemption 2, which is fantastic. Case closed. You should keep all your monitors, maybe buy a few more. We're gonna have some nice ones linked in the video description. But wait a second, that's a lot of bar left down there. Ah, okay. That's because the story is far from over. In that same scenario, we lost nearly 7% of our performance in Total Warhammer 3, with Cyberpunk 2077 landing in the middle at just over 3%. Obviously, these aren't earth-shattering numbers, and the impact is lower if you only run 2 displays rather than 4, but I was still surprised by how significant the performance impact was. And this is on a top-of-the-line machine. And it gets worse. I mean, given that 4K is literally 4 times the pixel count of a 1080p display, it probably won't surprise you much that our performance loss was even more substantial. Total Warhammer 3 actually improved, going down to 5%, but Red Dead and Cyberpunk shot up to around 7% if we had video playback running on our 3 extra screens. The real story, though, is that this doesn't just apply to your average frame rates, where, realistically, in most of these games, you can probably spare a few FPS. It also applies to your 1% lows, the situations where 8 to 9% difference could be noticeable as hitching or additional stutter in your gameplay. Now, in fairness, this is an extreme example, and most people aren't going to be running 3 full-screen video instances while they game. But on the other hand, I don't think it's entirely unrealistic either. A streamer, for example, could easily have their game running here, their OBS preview over here, their live Twitch feed over here, and maybe a Let's Play or a walkthrough running on a 4th display. And the lower the performance of your PC, the more you're going to feel this difference. I mean, even a pro might struggle to notice 200 FPS versus 220 FPS, but 30 versus 33 when you're feeling those dips, that's something just about anyone could feel, even if they're not sure what's off about it. Which is all interesting, but doesn't answer why this is happening. To find that out, we reran our tests in 4K, but this time, without the video playback. And you might think, well, obviously outputting those 8.3 million pixels per display is gonna cost us something. But as it turns out, that's just not the case. our game benchmarks actually came back either the same as if we were on a single monitor, or about 1 FPS faster, which is weird, but low enough to chalk it up to run-to-run variance. So what's the catch then? Pushing more pixels means our computer's working harder, doesn't it? Yes, but also no. When you have a static image that's just sitting on the screen in Windows, it gets stored in system memory. When a window gets dragged to a new position, it gets redrawn as needed. But if the contents of that screen need to be changing, all that optimization goes out the window. Watch this. I'm gonna move around the sign-up sheet for our stubby screwdriver launch here, by the way. Be the first to know. Sign up and don't miss it. Got that linked in the video description. I shake it around and we see an immediate spike in 3D GPU usage, but then I stop and boop, it goes away. Then, if I wanna kick things up a notch, rendering animations or decoding a video will put additional load on the GPU. Oh, like this, the LTT desk pad configurator where you can put in the size of your desk and what kind of desk pad. Ooh, look at that usage, yikes. Though again, in fairness, that's a little unrealistic, so why don't we just go with something that's closer to our test and play back a video where 3D usage, not so bad, but video decode starts to pop off. You're gonna see this. Depending on the load, there will be some usage. It's not that much, and it's mostly not on the parts of the GPU that your 3D games rely on, but it obviously is something. Of course, this isn't the first time we've learned this lesson. Years ago, if you wanted to stream to Kick, the best option was to use a second computer to capture and encode your stream. But that all changed when NVIDIA introduced NVENC and NVDEC, which offload encoding and decoding tasks to dedicated hardware on their GPUs. It was a game changer, and it has enabled more than just streaming from a single PC. Remote Play, for example, relies heavily on NVENC and NVDEC. However, their promise that with decoding and encoding offloaded, the graphics engine and the CPU are free for other operations wasn't entirely true. NVENC has always come with a measurable hit to in-game performance. And as we've seen here today, this is also true for decoding and for running extra displays. Even if it's as small as reallocating the power budget that's needed to fire up those other functional units on the GPU, it will cost you something. However, even as a one monitor guy, both at home and at work, I am not gonna tell you to throw away your secondary display. For all but the most competitive gamers out there, the benefits of multi-monitor probably far outweigh the drawbacks. However, as a one monitor guy, even if you're not worried about the performance loss you've seen here today, there are some reasons that I do prefer a single screen. There's less to troubleshoot when video issues arise, it requires less power and less cable management, and most importantly for me, for gaming, I find it more immersive. Not only can you dive right in without a second monitor stealing you away through your peripheral vision, but as someone who really needs a break when I take time to game, I appreciate that I never see notifications popping up on that other screen. Of course, none of that makes a difference for you if you need to have Twitch chat up or whatever else. So for those of you who are looking for a second monitor, it is true, by the way, we do have some displays linked down below, and I wanna especially shout out Sony for providing the displays that the lab used for our testing. It's a super nice one, we did a full short circuit video, and we're gonna have that one linked down below, along with some other affordable and more premium options. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out the one where we explored motherboard performance with 10 different motherboards and one CPU. Once again, I think the results might surprise you.